ప్రేక్షకులకు నమస్కారం. ఈరోజు మన స్టూడియోకు నాగ్పూర్ నుంచి ప్రముఖ హృద్రోగ శస్త్రచికిత్స నిపుణులు డాక్టర్ ఆనంద్ సంచేటి గారు వచ్చినారు. వారు నాగ్పూర్లో న్యూరో హాస్పిటల్ డైరెక్టరు, అదేవిధంగా ఇండియన్ అసోసియేషన్ ఆఫ్ కార్డియోథొరాసిక్ సర్జన్స్ సంఘానికి వారు అధ్యక్షులు, ఏడాదిగా వారు అధ్యక్షులుగా ఉన్నారు. వారు చిన్నప్పుడు చదువుకున్నది వరదలో చదువుకున్నారు, మహారాష్ట్రలో వరదలో చదువుకున్నారు. ఆ తర్వాత కాలేజీ అకోలా వద్ద అమరావతిలో చదువుకున్నారు. ఇది తర్వాత MBBS వరదలోనే చేశారు. MS ఆయన నాగ్పూర్లో గవర్నమెంట్ మెడికల్ కాలేజ్ చేసినారు. MCS మాస్టర్ ఆఫ్ సిరర్జీని ఆయన కింగ్ ఎడ్వర్డ్ మెడికల్ కాలేజ్ ముంబైలో చేశారు. ఇప్పుడు వారు నాగ్పూర్లో న్యూయర్ హాస్పిటల్లో డైరెక్టర్గా పనిచేస్తున్నారు.
దేర్ ఆర్ మెనీ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్ దిస్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ వరల్డ్ ఈస్ మోర్ ప్రివాలెన్స్ ఆఫ్ హార్ట్ డిసీజ్ ఇస్ దేర్. వీ నో దేర్ ఆర్ లాట్ ఆఫ్ రిస్క్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్ ఇన్వాల్వ్డ్ ఇన్ ఫార్ హార్ట్ డిసీజ్ రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ హైపర్టెన్షన్, డయాబెటీస్, డయట్, ఒబేసిటీ, ఓవర్ వెయిట్, సెంట్రల్ ఒబేసిటీ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ యూ కాల్, స్మోకింగ్, టొబాకో, ఎనీ ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ టొబాకో హ్యాబిట్స్, అండ్ ఎర్లీ ఆన్సెట్ ఆఫ్ డయాబెటీస్ ఆల్సో వెరీ ప్రివాలెన్స్ ఇన్ ఇండియా. బట్ దేర్ మస్ట్ బి సమ్ అదర్ ఫ్యాక్టర్స్, సమ్ జెనెటిక్ విచ్ వీ డోంట్ నో వై దిస్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ వరల్డ్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ సో మచ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్స్ ఆఫ్ హార్ట్ డిసీజెస్. లైఫ్ స్టైల్ సెడెంటరీ లైఫ్ స్టైల్ బికాస్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ నాట్ అవేర్ ఆఫ్ ఫుడ్ హ్యాబిట్స్. మీనింగ్ హ్యావ్ సెడెంటరీ లైఫ్, దే డోంట్ డూ ఎక్సర్సైజ్ యాజ్ వెస్టర్న్ కల్చర్ దే నో ఎవ్రీబడి టు సైక్లింగ్ అండ్ ఎక్సర్సైజ్. సో దట్ మే బి ద వన్ ఆఫ్ ద రీజన్ ఆఫ్ సెడెంటరీ లైఫ్ అండ్ ఫుడ్.
तो और ये इसके लाइफस्टाइल बदलने के लिए क्या करना चाहिए?
सिविल हॉस्पिटल देयर मस्ट बी एट ऑल लेवल टीचिंग प्रोग्राम शुड बी क्रिएटेड बाय गवर्नमेंट, बाय डिफरेंट डॉक्टर्स सोसाइटी, IMA, एंड एवरीबडी शुड कम अप विद ऑल विलेजेस मस्ट हैव सम पोस्टर्स, बैनर्स अबाउट एंड मेक अवेयरनेस अबाउट द डाइट एंड ऑल द रिस्क फैक्टर्स व्हिच आई हैव मेंशन. They should be explained to each and everyone, right from sarpanch level, from village up to the district level.
Andhra was banned when N.T. Ramarao was chief minister.
Right.
It was lifted after he died. So then coming to your Indian Association of Cardiothoracic Surgeons.
Right.
As professional body, you might be taking initiatives to improve health conditions in India by furbishing the image of the doctors and institutions.
No direct involvement in other association activities. Every association have their own organization, own power, but certainly I feel all the association must go together and plan a strategy. Like similar way I have met yesterday Dr. Sarat Kumar, who is very close friend of Dr. Prasad Rao, and because of Prasad Rao I could meet him. He is currently Cardiology Society of India's president, Sarash Chandra. So because of Dr. Sarash Chandra we have discussed lot of important thing, how two association can work together and contribute to our society and to the public, and how invariably country will get benefited if we start thinking on same line and form a common committee of both the association. So just putting independent force by each in a different direction, all together we can keep a single vision and move in one direction that will be giving more impact.
What will be the task of the committee, joint committee?
There are many developments are coming up in our field of cardiac surgery and cardiology. Like Western world is growing very fast. Initially, you know, they used to change the valve with open heart surgery only. Now without surgery, like angiography through catheter, we can replace the valve. And many things will develop. Future is catheter skill as far as valve and blockages in the coronary arteries are concerned. So to keep up with the pace of rapid development, what technology is coming, we must come forward together and form a heart team which will comprise of cardiologists and cardiac surgeon and cardiac anesthetist, so that we can keep the pace with the Western world, what is developing, and invariably the countries, each person, heart disease patient will get benefited.
And heart team, in layman's terms, how do you explain? We have to explain our viewers also. They are laymen. What is hybrid theater? What is heart team?
This came basically to make good and best possible approach for the patient, where he requires two or three treatments together, which are non-invasive for the patient, for the high-risk patient. For example, patient is having block in the kidney and he requires bypass also. So same time we can put stent in the kidney arteries, cardiologist will do that, we can do bypass. So in one sitting we can do two procedures. So that is heart team approach. So this type of procedure will have good result only when this three teams, cardiac anesthetist, cardiologist and surgeon, they will work together same time at same place. So and the reason behind forming heart team is to get best result for the patient.
They are reducing the prices.
Yes.
Price of the stent,
yeah,
and price of valves,
yeah.
Do they come down within the reach of common man?
Yeah, I think that decision was good what government has made, reducing and fixing the price of it. If that is successful in long term, and if we get same quality stent and all stent is available in that rate, that will be a good good decision, I will say, and it will definitely reduce the cost to the common people.
This medicated stents, yeah, drug coated stents,
yeah,
are still costly. And some stents like Boston Scientific Company stents are not available in Hyderabad for a very long
time. No, it has happened. Actually, government should have thought of this decision in more detail, I feel. They would have maybe created two categories, like they have created baseline maximum cost, cutoff cost is 30,000. Distributor can sell stent more than 30,000. In that, what has happened? The import of costlier or third generation stent has stopped, which were costing around 1 lakh earlier. So import is not feasible. So market are divided of those stents. So now everybody, even affording patient who wants to put best stent or third generation stent, they can't have. So I think something should be done on this matter, but otherwise this decision was good. Keeping a cap of 30,000 each stent is good decision, but they should have kept two categories for affording people or the where we require good quality stents, third generation, they would have kept cap of something around 60,000-70,000 for second category.
We are importing stents and valves.
Yes.
When do we start manufacturing in the country?
We are manufacturing. There are many companies, they are manufacturing stents. And one company which is manufacturing valve in India too, but the advancement which is going in India are slightly slower pace than Western world. Western world come up very quickly, and so we are more susceptible to use foreign stents or foreign valves. I think the whatever Indian valve and stent they have, they should come up with a quick advancement similar to the Western world.
So, World Health Organization fears that the incidence of disease will increase manifold in India. What do you suggest our viewers to follow? Lifestyle, food diet?
If somebody wants to live longer, I will, for layman, I will give some smart formula. If somebody wants to live 80 years, he should follow the 80 formula. He should eat 80 grams at one time, not more than 80 gram each time. He should have BP of diastolic, lower BP of 80. He should have weight less than 80. He should walk 80 minutes per day minimum and do exercise. He should have less than 80 centimeter of waist, so that central obesity is less, and he should have sugar of 80. So if we follow this 80 formula, right, sugar, BP, and eating less with frequent quantity, maybe he should have 5 to 6 meals, but of less quantity each time, an 80 minute exercise. So 80 formula for living 80 years.
Anand ji, as president of Indian Association of Cardiothoracic Surgeons, you may have your own vision and mission. You must have made some initiatives. What are those initiatives?
Yeah, last February I took over charge of president post in an Indian Association of Cardiothoracic Surgeons. As I told you, we needed to change the curriculum, and as a heart team approach, we wanted to represent government, Medical Council of India, and we have discussed in our executive committee, and so in few months we represented JP Nadda ji, Health Minister, and Medical Council of India, and given representation to include in our curriculum so that student can be trained right from his MCS training, and that is for that level we have represented, so that it invariably will contribute to the next generation for newer advancement. But after giving representation, we didn't get any reply either from Health Ministry or from Medical Council. So frankly, we lost the hope, and nobody could in our association can guided us what next to be done. And everybody thought that MCI only we have to represent again and again, and but suddenly I thought on that. I sat alone for many nights and thought, and I think waiting for government decision, and that will all and just not doing anything, it won't work. So we have started deciding on many factors. As a leader, I thought I should give vision to my executive committee, and I think I led them very nicely. I started some vision, like we have started catheter skill program. We had a talk with many hospital. Everybody has refused us that we cannot do tie-up with you and train the surgeon for catheter skill. But somehow with few doctors' help in Kanpur, I could get one of the hospital with the help of Dr. A.P. Jain and Director Dr. Vinay Krishna, who permitted me to do cardiac surgeons training from anywhere in India. They can come and do training here. So we have a tie-up at Kanpur Cath Lab. Now we are sending 12 surgeon batch-wise there to train in catheter skills procedures. Two batches are already over, and third batch will be due in next February 14th. So that will be every monthly program, and I think this year we will be training 40 cardiac surgeons for heart team approach. Now almost 100 cardiac surgeons in India we will be training this year to become a heart team approach. At student level, we have started from this year in association with IICT SCORE program. That SCORE program we have made started at Bangalore Satya Sai Hospital, where exam going student for 3 days they will be having all the cases presentation, theoretical training, clinical training, cases presentation, training on ECG, ECOS, everything we have prepared. So for that level student we have started program, then for newer advances catheter skill program, then after doing MCH students are not come to the level of independent practice, they have to spend almost 5-10 years for learning to become an independent cardiac surgeon. So for them, we have started many fellowship program. I have been to many places across the India. Recently, I have been to Ahmedabad and Kanpur also, the big hospital. We have done started a lot of fellowship programs. So after taking degree, surgeon has not to wait for many years. In 1 or 2 years, depending on his interest, he may be interested in just bypass surgery. He can take fellowship of bypass only. If somebody is interested in pediatric cardiac surgery, for complex pediatric cardiac surgery, he will do fellowship in pediatrics. So many fellowship we are starting, 3-4 fellowship, like heart transplant fellowship, they are in process. I am hopeful by next week I will be able to start 3-4 more fellowship, so that Indian surgeon will be trained quickly, they can contribute more to the country. These type of changes, some guidance should be led by president of all the associations, so that our country in health sector will grow faster.
So now once the skills are imparted,
yeah,
can a surgeon insert catheter?
Surgeon always were interesting. There are many surgeon I know, they were doing peripheral stenting. Not only surgeon, nowadays in India, radiologists are also doing all the stenting and this thing. There is no clarity in curriculum set by government of intimate. I don't know what is legality and illegality. None of the curriculum by Medical Council of India or Health Ministry are set something. But I feel the biggest achievement will be to combine cardiology, cardiac surgery and cardiac anesthetist to form a heart team, and they should lead for vascular intervention for all the vascular cases. That will be a biggest achievement. As the Western world is coming with heart team approach, we should not be lagging behind. That was the vision. I could start catheter skill certificate program. And yesterday I had a good meeting with Dr. Sarath Chandra, and he assured me that his association, Cardiology of Society of India, will join hand with us, and we will work together to form a heart team in future.